Gurren Lagann has a pretty impressive ensemble of characters, huh? They're well-defined, well-written, and well-designed. They leave impacts on the audience. But there is one that oftentimes goes without the love he truly deserves. Kitan. Let's talk about him, shall we? Kamina is definitely a long-lasting character for many, many people. He's bombastic, intelligent, he speaks his heart and spits out sensical nonsense that has touched people to their very core, both inside and outside the show. And he carries a heavy shadow, one that Simone bursts out of valiantly in episode 11 with a smile and an awesome speech. But one character, at least some, never managed to break free from Kamina's shadow, always staying behind. Kitan. Despite outliving Kamina, Kitan isn't as widely discussed in the fandom. Kamina was the smile we couldn't protect, the bro to end all bros, but what is Kitan? The other badass? Kamina but a bit dumber? No, my friends. He's much more than that. Let's take it from the top. Right at the very start, Kitan introduces himself as essentially a foil to Kamina. He had a similar bravado and was equally loud, but he carried experience. While Kamina was a learning gunman pilot who was brand new to the surface, Kitan was a seasoned beastman hunter, surviving on the surface with his siblings for an assumably long period of time without a need for a gunman. He was brash and bold, yet despite that, Kamina was still the main takeaway. Kamina speaks to the heart. He thinks, but also does. He's a man of many talents. So, again, I'll ask, what exactly is Kitan? Why isn't he remembered as fondly, at least generally speaking? I think it boils down to this scene in the adult arc, where Kitan explains it best.
I can't get the right words out.
You think?
If that guy was here, he would have done a better job of inspiring him.
When he rallied the troops, his words took a straight path to your heart.
But I don't really think that's a good enough reason, because Kitan differentiated himself from Kamina very effectively. It was clear early on that while they were similar, they had stark differences. Kitan wasn't a thinker. He didn't have the fluidity with words that Kamina had. He wasn't the crazy but protective big brother. No, but Kitan is the bro. Not like the blood brother, but like the best friend bro. He's a guy who tells it like it is. He's always there for you. After Kamina's death, Kitan was definitely the hardest on Simone. He didn't think the kid was ready to be the leader. And while he was right at the time, and everyone else did think the same, Kitan was really the only one who would say it to Simone's face. He gave the honest, brutal truth instead of sugarcoating it. One could argue that Kitan even nudged Simone in the right direction by pushing him so much. It gave Simone perspective and it led him to Nia. Before Nia, but after Kamina, Kitan was briefly Simone's guy. And when Simone finally proved himself, Kitan realized he was wrong. So much so that Kitan proudly stood beside Simone through thick and thin. Even near the end, when almost the entire world was against him in the adult arc, Kitan was there fighting hard for Simone. He was willing to throw punches and stand up in court. It's an interesting flip seeing a character that at one point was so harsh on Simone fight the absolute hardest for him in his time of need. Like a true bro. Again, Kitan did the things that others wanted to, but chose not to. Kitan was a man of action, willing to take on the enemy with just a shotgun to save his family and friends. If there was a battle happening, or someone needed saving, he didn't hesitate. Kitan rushed headfirst in the battle because that's what he's good at, where he's the best. He didn't need an epic speech to weave words into a lasting moment. He was the moment. When Kamina was gone, Kitan was essentially stealing the scene. With his loud antics and a bravado that would make him the main character in most other anime, to quote Team 4-Star, he was the hype. His character arc in the second half of the show is basically him finding his place in the new world. He grew up on fighting, he grew up on action and fighting for his life, so politics and peace weren't his strong suit. He tried, but it just wasn't for him. He was stuck. He was happy to be there for his sister when she was having a baby, like a true bro, but was he destined to be the fun uncle? Was he destined to just be there and not live the life of a hero? In another life, maybe, but this Kitan was always meant to be a hero. He was more than willing to step forward and fight for humanity, give his life for humanity. He'd get his moment with the girl, get his epic line, and go out in a blaze of glory. So, I ask again, what is Keaton? He's the bro, the unsung badass stuck in a world of politics and drama, who chose to go out like a hero. He's action first, heroic. He is the bro. So, hope you guys enjoyed this video. What are your opinions on Keaton? Do you love him? Do you not like him as much? Are you like me and he's one of your favorite characters? Please let me know in the comments below. And as always, make sure to rate, comment, and subscribe. Check out my videos. Also, make sure to check my supporters. All their great stuff. Stay tuned for more Gurren Lagann month, and I will see you guys next time. Here's the heavens.